Hello, Monsters of Mayhem, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer 2, Immortal Empires, and part 5, I think. I want to say 5, but 5 of my Wulfric campaign. Wulfric's back, hooray! He had a bit of a tumble last episode, didn't he? But he's feeling better for it. He's nicely sat. His feet don't reach the ground. That, I feel, is that not a little bit unbecoming? Doesn't matter, anyway. Over on the right flank, we've got a clash between Reichsguard and Skinwalls. One of our Skinwalls, the Midland Furries, are a little bit surrounded and taking a bit of punishment, but more units sweeping in, trying to wipe out that flank. We've got a lot of cavalry. Same with this flank, just one unit of Reichsguard this time, and they are taking an absolute beating. Wulfric is chasing after the squishy, squishy crossbowmen. Nice. Now, our Marauders are doing okay. Our Berserkers, though, are doing very, very well, as you'd expect, really. The Berserkers are they're actually fighting Karl Franz at the moment. There we go, the Skinwalls now free to do their dirty work, getting behind the enemy lines, having dealt with the enemy cavalry. One unit of cavalry is actually breaking away. Another unit of cavalry is attacking Wulfric. We're chasing after them, but they seem to be... The AI has this very annoying ability to just get its cavalry wherever it needs to be. If you need to get your cavalry out of a fight, it's actually quite annoying because, for example, if your unit's like engaged, if one of your cavalry members is left behind, the likelihood is the entire unit will turn around when you go off to do something else and come back to that fight because that unit is technically in combat. The AI, on the other hand, never has to worry about that. As such, our poor Marauder Hunters over here who are trying to finish off a unit of Reichsguard, there's only 13 of them left. Make that 10. I'm going to get charged in the back, despite the fact that we have the Chaos Cooties coming up, but... Yeah, well... nasty charge there. That's rude. But then the Chaos Hound's coming in behind, and suddenly the Sable's going to turn. It's looking okay. We have the upper hand here. Karl is... He's still fighting. He's up to 50 kills. He's killed a lot of stuff. We've now got Melek in here. I need to rename these guys. I don't have a good, like, rename system for the... I don't know what to do. I'm taking the renames off the Discord. So if you've got a good name, put it on the Discord, because otherwise, it's just really hard to see. These Karaburg Greatswords. These guys, are they unbreakable? Yeah, they are unbreakable. They also have this blood thing. What does that do? Increases melee attack and leadership for everyone around them. That's a pain in the ass, isn't it? I mean, mind you, my Marauders have 74 melee attacks, so I can't really complain, I guess. Forgotten to rename, that's ironic. Alanis Morissette would be wryly amused by such things. Probably, if she knew what irony meant. Which might be ironic in itself, who knows. So the Karaburg Greatswords are getting cut down from behind by... You see the fucking Berserkers, they're just great. And the Skinwalls coming in, having dealt with the last few units... We did take quite a lot of damage. You know what? I thought this would be easier. But it turns out, no. Well, the Empire's ability to recruit shit tons of Reichsguard, Halberdiers, and Greatswords is probably not the best thing in the world, but, you know, it's fine. We won the battle. Gonna sack Eelhearts. Ooh, a Gift of Chaos of Regeneration. That is not bad. Now, they only have, what? Do you only have three settlements? We've got Reichshammer. Melee attack, melee defense, leadership. Good.
I will hear your petition, but make no promises to...
Shut up. You've got three settlements. One, two, yeah, so you've literally just got some of Reichland. Not even all of it. Got Grunberg. Is that one down? Who? Right. Who? What? No, that's Eelhart. So they've got that one over. Right, okay. So at least they're at war with the Greenskins now. So the Orcs that control Midland are now at war with them. That's going to make life a little bit difficult for the Empire, which makes life easier for us, in theory. We're just going to scooch over here, do a little bit of raiding, something like that. Now, what we do need is a little a little shaman sorcerer. And it's got to be of metal. Hold the line. Enemy leadership is not necessarily the worst. Diabolic splendor or determined? Well, extra melee defense isn't the worst thing to have. But minus any enemy leadership is just too good. So, right, we're going to get you. Good. And you're Thyrus, because that's one of my Discord mods. Bless him. And he deserves it for the abuse I put him through. So we're going to bring Thyrus down here to come and help me out. Give me a little bit of magical support, because God knows I think we need it, don't we? Holy shit. I mean, last time didn't go very well. Well, I say didn't go very well. It went fine. You know, apart from, you know, almost getting my army wiped out and Wolfric dying. But, you know, ultimately, I feel like I am very, you know, I don't, plans, who needs plans? I'm very much a leaf on the wind of destiny, heading towards the muddy puddle of fates.
I travel the world seeking
and tools. The seven seas. I am watching you through a cam. Oh, hello. Okay. Okay, not the worst thing. You I don't like. This I'm not a huge fan of. The Wasteland's going to rebel. Yeah. Well, you know, these things happen. It's Philippe.
A challenge? Done as done.
I'm going to go here and I'm going to just sack you. Ultimately. Or do I want to do a little raise? You know what? I'm just going to sack you because I don't trust this army over here.
Speak.
So we're going to sack you, and then we're going to run over here. And ideally, smashing the public order is... What? How much? We've got 66 public order. Really? Buildings plus 16? Jesus. Butcher, Kurgan slave thingy, doobie-doobie-doo. Wolfric has ranks up. Apparently, now, I thought this... It replaces rage. Okay, I was looking at... That is rage. So, wait, what? Because someone was like, you don't understand what that skill does. I'm looking at it, I'm going, it replaces rage. So, Fury of the Dark Gods gives me leadership, damage resistance, leadership, base, weapon damage, melee attack. Whereas, rage, leadership. Oh, I was looking at, no. Well, that's Berserk. Rage is the other one. Right, okay, I'm with you. No, got it. Right, yeah, okay, so actually it is good. Alright, we'll get Fury of the Dark Gods then, because that means... I mean, in my defense, the things that... It's confusing. It's fine. Now I have a blue angry face instead of the pirate face, apparently. Alright, good. Let's get Woundmaker for you. And did someone die in that battle? Or did we just not recruit enough? I probably didn't recruit enough. Never mind. We'd got Thyrus heading down here to join us anyway. So, you know, he will rock up. Oh, we're actually getting positive public order there. Jesus. Wonders may never bloody cease. Okay, let's get the shamanic pyre. Because the question, what are we chucking? Are we chucking the shamans on the pyre? Is it a pyre of shamans? Or a pyre for shot? Is it to keep the shamans warm?
The eternal chalice.
Or is that the fuel?
A negotiation. How about this?
How about... yeah, I'll give you some money. I've got plenty of money, to be honest. Keeping you off my back is... Oh, look. Artois actually... I think they... Did they kill... Did Artois kill Marienburg? Or did they just suicide themselves? They suicide themselves. I mean, that's fine. I'm okay with that.
Sea Fang's ready.
I wonder if that means we can take that now.
I am the Wanderer.
I mean, potentially, but I'm kind of like more focused on... Oh, it's Volkmar's back.
Wolfric.
I mean, he was back. He's dead now. He's super dead now. Right, we're going to raise... You know what? I'm gonna go for a little bit of Zinch. And we've got more melee attack for everyone. Good. I mean, what? Okay, so what? the Dark Shards, who are our Berserkers, currently have 81 melee attack. That is before Frenzy, because Frenzy is an effect which works on them during battle, so it's not even taking that into account. So technically they have almost 90 melee attack in battle before any other bonuses. I mean, that's just fucking ridiculous. That's off the chain. That's bonkers, that is. It's absolutely... ambush success chance is not the worst thing to have. I don't know if that affects us. I don't think it... Does it? Plus 15 for mammoth units. I mean, we're probably going to have mammoth units anyway, right? Currently we've got 64 melee attack. Okay, it doesn't affect us, but, you know, still, more mammoths. That's good. Can't go wrong with mammoths. I wonder if we can get the Empire to, like, resettle Illheart. I mean, they're strength rank 99. They're not doing very well. They're at war with a few factions. They don't have many friends. The Empire, I mean, Midland has been torched. So it could, I mean, ultimately, I just need to stop the Order Tide. I don't want to spend the next 100 turns fighting the fucking Empire. That's, you know, ideally what I want to be sailing around the world, punching new and interesting people. I don't want to, you know, it's so dull when you're having to fight. Oh, you're going to rebel. What if I do that? You're fine. Okay, one turn, and then I can go and sort that little problem out, can't I? Let's do this. More Chaos Corruption and Defense. I would be surprised if we don't have another attack here fairly soon, would be my guess. There is a lot of Chaos Corruption here, though. Military Presence is beefing that up. At some point, I probably need to get another... Could I get another army now? Should I get another army? I don't know about that. I mean, when are you back? Three turns. I kind of want you back because you were not a totally useful... On the other hand, you've got the same... I mean, you know, one Cormac. Like, you know, the people who do the roads. You're level two already. You do reduce enemy leadership. I mean, shall we get Felmont? He is a tribal leader, isn't he? Okay, you're up, buddy. You're up. All melee attacks, not bad. This is going to... Okay, so that's... I'm not super interested in that. What does that do? Seduction of the Serpents makes you super sexy. Okay, meh. Regeneration, that's always good. Gives you Fireball. Yeah, that's all fine. I guess you could just get Root March for them. Right, what we're going to do with you is mostly just recruit some normal dweebs and put you in... Dieter Scharfen. So then, if they do come back, we've got more of a sort of like tanky force there to stop them, basically. That's the plan. Thyrus is continuing his little... He's on a little trip, isn't he? He's coming down to see us. He's been invited. He's been cordially invited to come and do some of his metal magic with the finger horns and all that.
Let me put you out.
What do you want? You want me to pay you for an non-aggression pact? No, that isn't happening. The only reason you're still alive is... Oh god, what's going on here? Refugees of War. Oh, Skeggy's dead. They don't have... I mean, Skeggy won't have anyone, will they? I guess... No, you won't have any Immortal Lords, so I'm just going to fucking kill him. There's no point. You've taken that. Right, well, you are at war with Altdorf, aren't you?
You are not welcome in my court.
Yeah, so, you know what? Knock yourself out, guys. You go and deal with that. I'm going to pop back here for a hot second. Let's get Thyrus in here to do a bit of scouting. We've got some little bits we could go and grab, to be honest. I mean, I would like to kill Marienburg. I'm hoping maybe the orcs can deal with Altdorf for us. I mean, it's Will they be able to? Unlikely, but maybe. I'm half tempted to replace, like, three of these with more berserkers. Because I can recruit berserkers now, can't I? Yeah, fuck it. Get rid of you guys. Where's my next? I can only recruit two at a time. I could get those in three turns. Maybe I'll do that. Basically, I the Marauders are fine, but the Berserkers actually do damage. Overrun the world. That's my thinking. You are going to... No. Don't, oh, for fuck's sake. Why? I don't know why it doesn't go... Oh, you want to travel from Eistrake Fjord to Dietershafen. Okay, well, we'll just sail rather than go... Oh, I'll walk around here. It'll take 50 turns. Enjoy. Enjoy your long-ass trip. So, right. We'll get the Berserkers. Then we're going to go on some trips to the sea. Just to see what's those little bits there. Might get some more money. Might get some we'll get some experience. All that kind of good stuff. And, oh, the Reichland's on the move. But that's not necessarily the worst thing. Because the Empire, or Reichland, even as a single, like, having just one city, just their one city, will still be redonkulously powerful and be able to spit out armies like nobody's business. The issue is, if they're contained around Altdorf, there's not much I can do. Because they've obviously got the garrison. I need to hit that city without a garrison. Well, or without an army nearby. Because I can't take on the garrison and the army at the same time. And, of course, if they've just got the one city, all their armies will be around Altdorf. And they will have multiple armies. And so I won't be able to break through. So, really, what I need to do is let them spread a little bit. And then take Altdorf. Because that's their main city. What do we have here? I think we could just all resolve that. Take the cash. We're an abductor. Good. Got monsters of the sea. More bonus experience. And treasury. I will take that. Let's pop back here. Probably could have fought that. And income from all buildings. Local region. Meh. Income from... Okay, that's all useless. That's all... Okay. Upgrade Searing Doom. Glittering Robe, pretty good. Plague of Rust, good. Gehenna's Golden Hounds, good. Transmutation of Lead, really good. Founder Transmutation, very good spell. All of these spells are really good. Basically, I feel like the metal school of magic is one of those, it just doesn't have a bad spell in it. Like, everything it has is just good. It's just good. Right, let us get another Berserker. We are losing a little bit of money, but it's not too bad. It's generally fine. We'll keep an eye on what's going on here. So obviously, they've burned Karoburg. So I guess we'll have to see what... Because it looks like they've still got two... They've still got two settlements. Their settler strength rank 99, so that means they're quite weak. They are also at war with a number of different factions, including Karak Ziflin. So, with any luck... Fingers crossed. With any luck, you know, enough of these factions will be just chipping away at them that I can slip in and knock out the Empire. Gisu is back. Good old Gisu. We're also severe. Fair enough. We are a bit angry, to be fair. Right. We... public order is not great here, but... Undefeated. I kind of need to go on the attack. This is a little bit dicey because I don't know what's going to go on over here. So let's lay a little ambush. Now. What's the public order here like? We're going to have a rebellion. I'm just going to accept that. Because there's bugger all I can do about it at the moment. So we're just going to see if we can lure whatever army is at Carab. Oh, that's like the Marienburg rebels. You know what? Not actually a big problem. We can kill them. It's more experience for us. What is going on there? That suddenly will go chaos-like? I genuinely don't know. Got a bit of a problem in that there's so many agents hanging around, particularly Marienburg agents, that it's going to be a real bugger to get any kind of like... ow. Where did they get Hellblast a Volley Cannon from? That's the question. Potion of Strength. Fair enough. You're going to heal up in one turn anyway. So, we're going to recruit... Fuck it. More Berserkers. Why not? I'm really tempted to just try and knock out Marienburg, because they're just being a massive pain in the ass. So I feel like maybe doing that. Good shouts. Manticore, Frost, melee attack for skin, melee attack and weapon strength for skin walls is good. Ambush success chance though could be a game changer.
I will not obey.
So we'll get that berserker. We will. Got raising it, so that's more bonus fighting in the Empire, which is good. Income from post battles not bad. Vigor loss reduction for cavalry isn't that most useful. I mean, we're not fighting a lot of. We're not fighting a lot of greenskins, vampires, or dwarves, or Tilly. It's weird that. It's. I guess it's because Miraglianio is like a capital. But it's a bit weird that it is a capital. And it's weird that Tilia is kind of ranked alongside the other larger factions, which is a bit odd. I mean, it's, you know, it's fine. But it's like missile resistance. Tilia is usually dead by now. You wouldn't, I mean, I guess the post-battle loot's quite nice. Do I want post-battle loot? Or do I want longer hulls? Income from sacking increased. Vigor loss reduction for marauder infantry units. You know what, let's get that. Let's get that. And Thyrus is going to get... Ooh, now. You know, I'm going to go... Do I want to go Plague of... You know what? No, I'm going to get Gehenna's Golden Hounds first. I do like Plague of Rust because you can drop it on, like, you know, some greatswords or something. And suddenly those greatswords are not as threatening because they've got, especially if you do the upgrade, 90... I think, is it 90 less armor? 90, or is it 60? I can't remember. They've got a lot less armor. It makes them far less threatening. Right, I think I've got to take out these dweebs, because if I don't, they're just going to continue to be a massive pain in the ass. Right, Bigby Wolf, you're immortal. Melek, you're immortal as well. Good job. We can upgrade this. Do I want to upgrade this? What's the public order? It's only going down minus 3 a turn, which is less bad than it was. Pretty much everything's still the same. I just...
To the four corners.
If I mean, I've just got so many friggin' agents. Unless I just go for the Empire and ignore them. Because, I mean, they can't recruit anything. It looks like the Empire's on the mark. You know what? I could potentially go for...
Wandering.
I don't really like leaving this, but... If we can hit Altdorf without an army there... I think we can take it.
My challenge?
Okay.
Undeniable.
Karl took Eelhearts, which means his army is probably weak, which means we could go and kill them. Before we do that, Ophirus, get Plague of Rust. It's 60 armor. Still, that's not bad. Oh my god, you've got a Hellstorm rocket battery, got war wagons. That's all not fun. Okay, let's fight this one just because... Oh god, where did they get... Have they got okay. Here's a little trick you may not know. If the enemy AI has an artillery piece, and you've got units that can vanguard deploy...
The omens are good, brothers!
Good. It really does fuck them up if you put them behind them. So we've got the Chaos Cooties behind here. We've sent them after the Hellstorm Rocket Battery. Now, they won't be able to get it because, I mean, if they attack that, they're going to get ripped to pieces. They don't need to, though, because as long as they're advancing and close to the Hellstorm Rocket Battery, it will constantly try to reposition itself to get into a good firing position, which, of course, it won't because, you know, we're constantly going to be moving around. Thyrus getting his first... Look at that. First spell of the campaign from Thyrus. No kills. Probably fine. So as we're using the Chaos Cooties to sort of like flank around, the Hellstorm Rocket Battery has got no shots off. We're going to send in Melek here, so we engage the Hellstorm Rocket Battery, because then if the Reichsguard charge them, it's not going to be too much of a big problem. All of our Berserkers now sweeping in. We're going to debuff the shit out of these Greats. So these Great Souls now have 65 armor, and look how quickly their health starts dropping. And that's 30. If we could double that up to 60, holy shit. We're taking that health. That Hellstorm rocket battery got no kills. Zero bloody kills. And the Chaos Cooties, of course, good anti-large units. And, of course, they'll have got some armor-piercing as well. Going to come and knock out those war wagons. Skin walls. I mean, these mortars, how many kills do they get? They got one. What? One. One kill. And elsewhere, everyone's just being overrun by the sheer weight of Marauder Berserkers, who I kind of love with their ridiculous amounts of weapon strength. Hello, boys. Push them back to their foul longships. I have you know our longship's lovely. It could use the women's stuff. You know, we could use some soft throws and stuff. Maybe some potpourri in the centre. But otherwise, I mean, really, we could use some sort of air freshener in there. It's very stuffy. Very stuffy indeed. And that's the problem when you've got you're just cramming a lot of very naked, sweaty men in together. It smells like... There was once I went to a Games Workshop to do... Like, they were doing some event. I think it was like an arc or something. The Skaven had an arc and they were doing battle. Anyway, I was in Guildford. Went to the Games Workshop. My mother once said I walked in and it just smelled of teenage boys. And it was awful. And I imagine that's a lot like this probably smells. Or at least the longship smells. So, maybe some air freshener. You know, just a quick squirt. Especially with the skin walls. I bet those boys probably smell awful when they're wet. I know we're kind of dancing around the Empire at the moment, but that's with good reason. Because if we don't, we could be in a lot of trouble. All it's going to take is one bad move from us. Oh, Armor of Destiny. That's quite nice. Oh, and the Miststalkers. That's very nice. The Eternal Challenger. One wrong move and we could end up like surrounded like last time. And we don't want that, because that would not go well. I don't think plus 15 arm piercing damage is really going to change my life. So I'm thinking we get the is it skin walls? There we go. Yeah. Let's get that. Now, unfortunately, if we raise a settlement... Oh, God, have we... Oh, because, of course, it drops the... I'd forgotten that when you do a tribute to a different god, it reduces the other four, doesn't it? Yep, that's... I remember now. Overrun the world. All right, how long before we have extra growth? Eight turns, and we'll be able to upgrade that to top rank. I mean, I would like to see if maybe we could, like, get these guys on side, but I feel like it's going to be really, really tricky to do that. They are currently fighting a lot of people, though, so they are keeping a lot of people busy. They're actually heading down into the Empire. So at this rate, they might actually be keeping some of the heat off us, allowing us to concentrate on the Empire. And I realise that, yes, we're kind of dancing around the Empire a lot. But it's one of those cases where if we get in a bad position... All it's going to take is one wrong move and we get wiped out and then we have to restart this entire thing again. So I would prefer to take it just a little bit slow. Just because when I get overly aggressive, things go bad. Well, seeing as you ask, my challenge, undeniable. I think we're going to have to head back to Marienburg. Well, do we want to do that? Well, yeah, we probably do actually. So let's hop into there. I mean, plus it's going to let us, like, upgrade Thyrus and the rest of our units and potentially get, like, magical items and stuff, which will be really useful. You know what? Reducing armor by 60 is just so good. As we saw in that previous battle, that unit of greatswords went from being, you know, trouble to suddenly not so much trouble because you just... It's like giving a unit plus 30 armor piercing, or in this case, plus 60 armor piercing, and just letting them get on with it. Especially with a unit like the Marauder Berserkers, who have got such a huge amount of weapon strength. The only thing they don't have is armor piercing. So if you remove the enemy's armor, then suddenly your Berserker is going to be doing a shit ton more damage. Okay, we're going to give you the Armor of Destiny, because that's actually decent armor. I would love if we had a better weapon and stuff, but we don't, so never mind. You, on the other hand, yeah, sure, I have some armor. I don't think we've got anything else we can give you. Well, we could give you Frenzy, but I don't know if that's actually that useful. You know what, I never remember to cast Fireball, so have one of those. Also, Do more corruption. More post-battle loot would be good. Income from more buildings is not the worst thing. More chaos corruption. Yes. And everyone else has got everything else. That's fine. You've got the potion of strength. We don't have any of that stuff. You've got an obsidian trinket. You've already got frenzy. And you already cause fear. Have a talisman of protection then. And you can have another... You can have a potion of strength. That you've got one of those. That's all good. Okay. So far, not... Not bad. Tribal fury. I could send you out to do some raiding, but I don't think that's probably a good idea. You'll probably end up super dead. I'm really tempted to knock out Marienburg, but the thing is, they're not actually doing anything. They've got some agents, which are kind of a problem, but that's about it. You know what I'm going to do? Is I'm actually going to...
My challenge?
Get rid of you. Get these. That is going to increase my... Thing is, these guys, fucking ludicrous. So their armor sundering, they've got magical attacks, their stats are redonkulous. They're just a really good unit, and the Famir in general, probably one of the best units in the game. They may not be Minotaurs, but they are pretty close.
I've little time for talking. But much.
What do you want? More gifts? Sure. I've got plenty of money, and to be honest, it keeps you off my back. You're keeping some other people off my back. It's well worth the cash. If I can just knock out goddamn Empire. If I can just knock out the goddamn Empire.
Okay.
Again, we're going to do some raiding. Missile resistance isn't the worst. You do get weapon strength as well. I think we're going to go. I want to go Nurgle. I want to go full Nurgle. Because Nurgle is best boy. What strength rank are you? 65. Right. You've got at least two armies then. Would be my guess. At least two armies. Which would be fine if we could replenish in one turn. But we can't. So I'm just going to have to be very... if we get lucky, maybe like another faction... Oh, they've got plague! Holy shit, that...
A negotiation.
If we don't get plagued... Hello? Yeah, alright.
I've little time for talking.
Hello? Will you stop... Oh, fuck, just stop fleecing me. I'm busy. I've got shit to do. Right, they've got plague for three turns. If we can let that plague just tick away.
No escape.
Noir succeeds. Okay, good. Good for you. Good for you. Right, I want more public order here. Sure.
The eternal challenger. On the move.
Okay, Boris has got plague. So we'll do that. We'll sack it.
I am the wanderer.
And I'll do that. It's not as much replenishment as I would like. But if we can just give it. They'll be taking... Jesus, are you rank 5 or fucking ready? Good grief. Alright. What strength rank are they now? 50. I've killed an army, and yet they've gone up in strength rank. Good! That's fine!
My challenge? Undeniable.
That, I mean, it could be that other factions are, like, you know, lower than them anyway. So it's an indicator of how strong they are. It isn't perfect by any stretch of the imagination. Let's go with something like that. I reckon we can take them. I really do. I reckon we can take them. So, I would like more public order. So, we're going to... Is there more public order somewhere else? You know what? Let's get war tools, and then we can get something like, you know, more melee attack and defense for everyone. I really wish I'd kept my Nurgle. The extra casualty replenishment rate will be coming in useful quite a lot by now. But if we hit Karaberg again, we could potentially get what we need from that. And then we could hit Altdorf. And if we can take Altdorf, then the Empire should be as good as dead. Okay.
Where's my next quarry?
Your next quarry is right there. Right. Raise one for the crow.
To the four corners.
Right, if we hit Altdorf next turn,
the eternal challenge.
It's our best chance to take the city. It's going to be balls to the wall, and I wouldn't be surprised if we lose a lot of units, but if we can take it,
let's fight.
I mean, one, it counts as a Norsecan settlement. So we can then use that to hit other settlements nearby, replenish, recruit, all that kind of good stuff. But if there's an army there or something, but the plague's going to give us the best chance. Okay, the plague has faded from Altdorf, but we are in range. The berserkers are a little bit battered. There is an army in attendance, but it's only Conroy. Get out of the fucking way. Get out of the fucking way. Okay, those units are taking some damage. Makes life a little bit easier for us. I mean, it's by no means going to be a walkover, but it should be a lot easier. Fingers crossed. But that is going to have to wait until next time. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.